a jazz band out here that's going to perform.
Yeah, they already started one time, or they just getting...
Ladies and gentlemen, would you remain standing for an invocation by Reverend Willie Carter, pastor of Pilgrim Lodge Baptist Church.
Who saw a mill that the Hewitt lumbers provide materials to build churches, homes, and schools. Not only to supply this community, but to supply to those throughout this nation of ours and throughout the world. We thank you for the faith they had. We know it took blood, sweat, and tears to hew down the large trees and remove the stumps to build the foundation upon which we stand this day. So as we come to celebrate this 180-year anniversary, let us be grateful for the faith that they had in this community. And ask that thou would grant us the same faith for our present as they had over a century ago. We thank you, O God, for the sacrifices they made, for the contribution that they made throughout this nation. And most of all, we thank you for this historic society, all of these members who made up their mind and determined that the effort made here will never be forgotten. Even though the effort and the work they've done here has ceased, it would have been forgotten, never entered into the pages of history had it not been for this society. So we thank you, God, for the effort that they are making, and so that generations present and generations come, and those who are yet unborn, will know that this little community made a great contribution, not only here in Central, but throughout this nation. We thank you for this day. We thank you for the weather we have. We now pray for all the participants who will come to celebrate on this day. And may we all go away from here with fond remembrance and determination that this nation will never be forgotten. In Jesus' name we ask you. Amen.
Thank you, Brother Carter. I failed to mention that Brother Carter is, both of them were in the Union Army. Well, they both made their own fortunes. Martin Sullivan in Pensacola, he had extensive timber holdings. R.A. Alger made a fortune in Michigan with his extensive timber holdings. And somehow they got together and decided that all this virgin timber around here in Northwest Florida and South Alabama, that meant dollars. They saw those green pine needles as gold. And sure enough, they got together, formed the Alger-Sullivan Syndicate in 1900, bought the mill that was already in operation up in Foshi out from Bruton, and because of one thing and another, they decided to build a large mill down here right across the state line in Century. Now, if it were not for Escambia County, Alabama, Monroe County, Alabama, Kaneka County, Alabama, the town of Century would not even be in existence today. The town of Century, or the community of Century, was actually built. Where you're standing right now was very likely a pasture of Mark Mayo. Mark Mayo was settled here. The house that he built probably around 1880 is still down at the end of the street here. They came in and bought land from Mark Mayo and built the town. And, of course, there were some other people that they had to buy some land from, too. But Mark Mayo owned all of this around here. It was all pasture, and it was all his. So when they came in, they built the mill with lumber that was produced in Foshi. And in 1901 is when the actual building of the town and the mill commenced. And they had to have a spur coming in from the LNN Railroad. So the LNN said, you need to create a name for this depot or this junction here. So Mr. House, who was secretary, president, chairman of the board, all of these things for over 50 years, wrote Mr. Alger and asked him, we'd like to name the town Alger. Would you agree to that? That was in about February of 1901. And at that time, all his letters were postmarked Hammock, Alabama, up close to Foshi. And then in April of 1901 was the first letter that said Century, Florida. And it was a letter from House to Alger that said, we have decided to name the new station Century. So, Century wasn't 1900, it was 1901. And I won't try to bore you with facts and figures from all the other things, but over the years, Alger-Sullivan was at its peak the leading producer of southern pine timber, longleaf yellow pine, in across the whole southeastern United States, probably east of the Mississippi, maybe even the whole country. And of course, it went into to decline when the virgin timber began to be cut out. And in 1957, the company decided to sell out, and the town no longer had a major industry. So we're trying to preserve the memories of what happened, as Brother Carter mentioned in his prayer. The people that were here before us, they worked very hard. The people in Alabama, which actually created, the jobs were created up there for them by the people that came down here from up north. The Alger-Sullivan Lumber Company was a major logging railroad company. You see the old 100 over there in pieces. We were hoping to have it even further along, but there have been some setbacks and haven't got much done on it over the last 2 years since it's been here in Century. But I wanted to mention one other thing, that there's a book that's very comprehensive that was written by a man named Thomas Lawson out of Birmingham. Mr. Lawson said that the Alger-Sullivan Lumber Company was the premier number one logging railroad in Alabama, even though the sawmill was in Florida. Now I want to, Miss Connie, are you around somewhere? The Jazz is coming up, and Miss Connie said that she was going to do a little dance routine before they start. You want to come over? Oh, that's pretty good. That's pretty good. Did you want to introduce anybody or introduce your group?
I would just like to introduce the group and let you guys know this is the J Jazz Band. We call ourselves J Jazz. This is our debut performance. So please be patient, but I've got wonderful students. So if you would give us just a moment to do some fine tuning, then we'll play 5 songs for you guys. Some of them you will recognize, some of them you might not, but it's all jazz. So we just hope you enjoy it, and thank you for inviting us.
While she's getting walking up to the front of the stage there, I want to mention that we're going to be giving away every hour, or about every hour, a series of books. And if Jerry will give us the tickets and some of the books, you're the lucky person, you'll win those 3 scrapbooks. So Miss Connie, you go right ahead.
number 894819. This may be the final call for the winning ticket number for the free scrapbooks. Number 894819. If you don't have a ticket yet, be sure and check with us again. We're going to do this every hour or so. No cost for purchase of the ticket.
It's 10 after 9:30. I told them to be here so we'd go on stage at 9:30.
Okay, they'll
be here.
Well, do we get a winner?
Do we have a winner? 894-819.
That's why the mayor first. That's why they're drawing out.
Really?
Yeah.
I can't believe it.
You want to draw another?
Draw another one. Maybe one of these kids will win it. I'd like for them.
We need to draw so somebody wins. Young lady, would you reach in there and get a, you. grab a ticket, please.
Oh, we're having another number.
All right. Hold it.
Oh,
wait.
19.
Yeah. 894-819.
Play that to me.
All right. Okay. Thanks anyway.
You may know the peanut man. We'll have some more drawings in a little bit.
Where's my $1,000?
We go mail it to you.
Stand right there, guys. One in the washer.
Okay.
Enjoy. Your number will stay in there.
You see all the time you'll be in here.
We can't do that, can we? His number.
No, not his number.
I can't get him.
Yeah.
Children from Campfire USA. We're in Century. It's called Campfire USA Youth Learning Center. We have children from 1-year-old all the way to 13. And matter of fact, right now we're doing summer camp registrations, and it's for anyone from kindergarten to the age of 13 for the summertime. It starts in June 1st and it ends the Friday before school starts back. But Campfire has been around for, next year they'll have been around for 100 years. It used to be Campfire Girls, but now, and several years ago, they decided to add the boys in there, so it became Campfire USA, and it's for boys and girls. And they're fixing to sing 3 songs for you that they've learned in class.
Thank you.
gave up on it.
Gentlemen, we are the Pilgrim Lodge Baptist Church Youth Choir, and we are going to be doing a few selections for you. Good morning, and praise God.
works here. He's still working.
He's still working? And the camera's still working?
I hope he knows what he's doing.
He got it. Right, you never know, all but right. Well, we got
people here from Molina.
Ladies and they have classes every Thursday at 6 a.m. If you could wake up that early, then you can go take a class. Barbara George and the Southern Pride dancers from Atmore, Alabama, they have classes every Thursday at 6 p.m.
Little by three, if I hold my mind, it's on the door, closing the door, knocked down this weekend, about three houses.
Themselves, but I guess they forgot their names. I believe that's Henry Leonard, Danny Leonard, Bobby Holland. Right, I got that right? No gymnastics necessary. What we're going to do now is introduce the sawmill winners, sawmill beauty pageant winners. Farron, would you come up? And Don Sales. Don Sales is going to talk about the Lions Club, who is a sponsor of the sawmill pageant. And Don is trying to sell something as usual. Don't buy anything from him, lady. He used to sell used cars. Oh, as long as it ain't a Ford. Fix or repair daily. Oh, don't let me insult anybody.
Hey, man, I own one.
Hey, Don. Don Sales. Now, you do not have to stand and bow. Even though Obama does.
It's hard to follow that right there, but I am Don Sales, and I'm with the Historical Society and also with the Century Lions Club. And we just put on a beautiful beauty pageant in Century and had 50-something contestants and some beautiful winners that night. And some of them are here today, and they'll be coming in and out all day today, and we have a certificate for each one of them that Farron is going to give to each one. Now, if you don't know anything about the Century Lions Club, every time we raise money, it's to give some child eyeglasses. We provide any child of school age that needs eyeglasses with their eyeglasses. So anytime you donate money to the Lions Club, that's what it's going for. And right now, I'd like to introduce Farron Bevis, and she was the host at the beauty pageant, and she's going to be handing out these certificates, and we appreciate every one of the contestants that came that day and that is here today. So thank you very much, Farron.
All right, I have the certificates here for the contestants. These are all the contestants and all the winners, all together, everybody who participated. I'm going to call out everybody's name. So if you're here, if you're present, please come up and get your certificate. We have Faith Johnson, and I think she was our Miss Century Sawmill winner. Taylor Nicole Cartwright. Paige Smith. Kaylin Garnett. There you go. Kaylin is our preteen Miss Century Sawmill queen. Thank you, Kaylin. Chelsea Brady. Brittany Michelle Cartwright. Auburn Nicole Jernigan. Summer Allen. Alana Nicole Gordon. Chloe Madison Smith. Heather Alyssa Hilton. Bailey Dumas. Valencia Ariana Burnett. Valencia is our junior Miss Preteen Queen. Our junior Miss Queen, no preteen. Leah Danielle Nall. Lana Harris. Sabrina Rowland. Laurel Sims. Wyatt Landon Holland. We also have boys who participate in our pageant also. Ainsley Brooke LaSala. Braden Walker Reeves. Rowdy Fretwell. McKenna Anderson. Aiden Paul LaSala. Brianna K. Hart. Alyssa Rutherford. Alana Lowry. Lily Nicolette McCall. Harley Rose Wilson. Chloe Alexis Hilton. Mallory Bell. Bristol Marie Rose. Jordan Elizabeth Sanders. Camden Allgood. Caitlin Welch. Natalie Claire Hendricks.
Olivia Lee Beasley. Layla McCullough. Sarah Elizabeth Williams. Brooklyn Humphreys. Andrea Grace LaSala. Allie Elizabeth McGraw. Kaylin Carly Franklin. Bailey Lee Fillingham. Addison Faith Ecker. Carlissa Spears. Kendall Allie McDonald. Aaliyah Destiny Farrell. Bailey Marie Lincoln. J.C. Annalie Holland. Mary Addison Jernigan. Rachel Ray Sapp. Gracelyn Marie Fretwell. And that's all. Thank y'all so much.
I'm gonna try to keep a tab on the sound. Help you out a little bit. I'm going to tell you,
It's only when we're blind beneath the blood of God's own Son. Oh, there's a river of mercy flowing from God's throne, and it washes the sin away from everyone who comes. He's extended so everyone can go to this river of mercy and be washed white as snow. This river of mercy. look up high. What shall I see in the eastern sky? This could very well be the day that the church will be called away. No man knows the hour, no man knows the day that the church will rise to be here and the saints will fly away. Or didn't I hear a trumpet sounding mighty near? I see a hand reach down, motioning. late at night, talking it over, me and God. You could save your life, father and son, me and God. He's my father, he's my friend, the beginning and the end. He rules the world with a staff and a rod.
because he has spared our lives. We had to bury anyone, so we just thank God for that. And we praise God for it. And it is a blessing to return to this celebration. Our first song will be Run and Tell That. Have the Lord done anything for you? Yes, sir.
You ought to run and tell that.
Pick me up and turn me around. Place my feet on solid ground.
You ought to run and tell that.
Oh, you.
Oh,
yes,
Hey, Jerry, will you turn it up?
Amazing. when we've been there 10,000 years, bright shining as the sun. We've no last days to sing God's praise than when we first begun.
Here in Century, Florida. My name is Jeremiah Hart. I'm the assistant pastor. My dad, Steve Hart, is the pastor at Tabernacle Baptist Church here in town. And over here to my left is my wonderful wife, Sarah. We've been married a little over 5 years, and we have two children, Jacob and Isaac, two boys that keep us busy quite all the time, in fact. And then also back here getting stuff together with the sound is my youngest brother, Daniel. And all of our last name, of course, is Hart. Hers wasn't until we got her right into the right family after that. But we do a little bit of picking, as you can see, a little bit, not as good as what some people do. But we also, gospel music is what we've been raised on. I mean, that's what we've sung all of our life, what we've heard all of our life. And we enjoy being able to sing it for other people. And the Lord has blessed us to be able to sing and to be able to come out here today to be able to share just a little bit with you today. And so we also not only do instruments with the strings, but we also, my wife plays the piano. And since we don't have a piano out here, we recorded some of her piano playing. And we're going to sing some gospel songs that have been a blessing to us through the years. And so we just hope that you enjoy it just a little bit today as we try to lift up the name of our wonderful Savior, Jesus Christ. If it wasn't for him, we wouldn't be able to sing this music. We wouldn't be able to stand or breathe or anything like that today. So listen as we sing a couple of songs for you.
Trusting in his word, I'm not ashamed to lift up high the blood-stained banner, because I'm saved, I'm not ashamed.
Sometimes we as Christians, we wait upon the shelf, but we're ashamed to lift our heads in praise. We wait on someone else, but Jesus died on Calvary. God's plan he did fulfill, and that is why I stand today trying to do his will. I'm not ashamed
to stand and say that I love Jesus. I'm not ashamed to say I'm trusting in his word. I'm not ashamed to lift up high the blood-stained banner, because I'm saved.
life we have his blessings, yet we fail to praise his name. He said if we were ashamed of him, to us he'd be the same. When he gave his life on Calvary, he did it for all men, so that I can stand and proudly say, I've been born again, I'm not ashamed to stand and say that I love Jesus. I'm not ashamed to say I'm trusting in his word. I'm not ashamed to lift up high the bloodstained banner, because I'm saved. I'm not ashamed, because I'm saved. I'm not ashamed.
But then a man on Christian soldiers fighting Satan every day. We're standing up for Jesus while we're kneeling down to pray. If his precious blood has cleansed you and has washed away your sin, that makes you a member of the blood-washed band. Praise God, I'm a member of the blood-washed band. I've been washed in the soul-cleansing blood of the Lamb. I was bound by the chains of sin till one day the Master came and made me a member of the blood-washed band. God's children are advancing, march until we reach the goal. For the battle's almost over, we'll soon be going home. I can hear the sound of angels as the saints go marching in, singing praises to the captain of the blood-washed band. Praise God, I'm a member of the blood-washed band. I've been washed in the soul-cleansing blood of the Lamb. I was bound by the chains of sin till one day the Master came and made me a member of the blood-washed band. I was bound by the chains of sin till one day the Master came and made me a member of the blood-washed band. I tell you what, I thank God that I'm in that band. There may be many different clubs that you could be involved with when you're down here on earth, but the best one that you can be involved with is that you're in the family of God. I tell you what, that is definitely what it is. This next song, I believe it's number three, isn't it? Kind of going back to what we sang with the song a minute ago about that I could still go free. We're going to get my youngest brother Daniel here in a minute to be able to come up and sing the first verse of this one. And who knows what's going to happen? And if you watch the news nowadays, who knows what's going to happen with this economy that's going on around here? And every time you look at it, you're like, I don't know if we're going to survive this thing or not. And you may think that with your financial situation, you may be in some type of a financial bondage. I tell you what, sometimes you look at your paycheck, you look at your bills, and you're like, this ain't going to add up. And it feels like you're in prison sometimes with that. And in this life, there may be a lot of things that seems to bind you down. But as this next song says, you have Jesus in your heart. You are free from so many things that you, from sin, from this life down here. And this is my youngest brother Daniel comes and sings, I'm free. For so long I had searched for life's meaning, enslaved by the world and my greed. But then the door of my greed
believe. It's heaven's jubilee. One of these days we're going to get to see everybody that we've read about in the Bible, and different people that we've had in the face of our lovely Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Listen as we get ready to sing heaven's jubilee.
Some glad morning we shall see Jesus in the air, coming after you and me, joy is ours to share. What rejoicing there will be when the saints shall rise, headed for that jubilee yonder in the sky. Oh, what singing, oh, what shouting, on that happy morning when we all shall rise. Oh, what glory, hallelujah, when we meet our blessed Savior in the sky.